Hey, Freckle family. Welcome back to Movie Mondays. It's August 14th, and I'm your host, John Bailey, a.k.a. the Epic Voice Guy. And I'm excited to be back with you again for another round of movie trivia. Freckle TV's daily trivia is the only game where you can answer 5 trivia questions every Monday through Friday to win incredible, epic sponsored prizes. All you have to do is play each day, earn tickets, and enter the raffles. Just that simple. But make sure you're signed into your Freckle account or creating your account today to be eligible to earn raffle tickets. Today we're exploring the wonderfully wild world of animated movies. So let's jump in to question number 1. Shanti is a character in which animated film? A. The Jungle Book, B. Moana, C. Mulan, or D. Frozen? Shanti is a young girl from a nearby village who befriends Mowgli, the main character raised by wolves in the jungle. She appears in the latter part of the film and plays a role in Mowgli's eventual decision to return to the human world. Shanti's character brings an element of innocence and companionship to the story, creating a connection between the human and animal worlds depicted in A, The Jungle Book. Moving on to question number 2. Who is Simba from The Lion King's childhood friend? Is it A, Scar, B, Timon, C, Pumbaa, or D, Nala?
She is a lioness and one of the central characters in the film.
She starts off as Simba's playmate and best friend during their cubhood in the Pride Lands. As they grow older, their friendship evolves into a romantic relationship. D, Nala plays a significant role in the story, encouraging Simba to reclaim his rightful place as king and join the battle against Scar, the antagonist. Together, Simba and Nala face various challenges and work towards restoring balance to the Pride Lands. Moving on to question number 3. Question number 3 is our sponsored question of the day. Let's check out a video from one of our sponsors. Shout out to our epic season 1 sponsors. Now, let's head to question number 3. What is the name of the villain in Cinderella? Is it A, Lady Tremaine, B, Ursula, C, Maleficent, or D, Gaston? Often referred to as the Wicked Stepmother, she is Cinderella's stepmother and the main antagonist of the story. She is depicted as a cold, cruel, and manipulative character who mistreats Cinderella and prevents her from attending the royal ball. A, Lady Tremaine is known for her iconic character design and memorable lines, making her one of the most recognizable Disney villains, and also the voice of Maleficent. Moving on to question number 4. What is the name of the company that Boss Baby works for in The Boss Baby? Is it A, Puppy Co., B, Baby Corp., C, Mega Babies Inc., or D, Toddler Enterprises? It's a fictional organization in the film that manages the affairs of babies and ensures their dominance in the world. Boss Baby, voiced by Alec Baldwin, is a suit-wearing talking infant who is a secret agent for B, Baby Corp. The film follows the humorous adventures of Boss Baby as he teams up with his older brother to uncover a plot involving puppies and an evil CEO. Moving on to the final question of the day. Which movie is this clip from?
Wow, look! Kid! No! Let me get... I'm not letting you undo all my hard work!
Is it A, Tangled, B, Big Hero 6, C, Zootopia, or D, Wreck-It Ralph? The film features numerous iconic video game characters and references from various eras of gaming history to create an authentic and immersive video game world. The D, Wreck-It Ralph filmmakers obtained official licensing agreements from multiple video game companies, including Nintendo, Sega, Capcom, and more. This allowed them to include popular characters like Bowser, Sonic the Hedgehog, and Q-Bert, among others, in the film. And they're gonna wreck it! And that concludes this today's round of Daily Trivia. Thank you so much for playing. Make sure you sign up for a Freckle TV account and set your user profile up after the game to start earning raffle tickets. Get ready for some music trivia tomorrow with Giuliano.
What's going on, Freckle Rockstars? How y'all doing today? It is Tuesday, August 15th, and I'm your trivia host, Giuliano Hodges. Now, so for all of our new players out there, Freckle TV's Daily Trivia is one of the only games where you can answer 5 questions every week to win dope prizes, from Funkos to collectibles to NFTs to gaming computers. They're amazing. You're in the right spot. Now, all you guys have to do is just simply play every day, answer 5 questions, earn raffle tickets, and then, boom, head to the prize marketplace. Wow. Every Tuesday, we're rotating back and forth between sports and music trivia. Today, it's time to break out those dancing shoes, dust off those vinyls, because it is music trivia, baby. Let's get started. Now, before we get started, I want to give a quick shout out to our amazing season one sponsorships, Sup Ducks, Manscaped, Jarritos, Anchor, Shell's Orb, and Magic Eden. Thank you guys so much. You guys are amazing. Now let's move on to question number one. What song plays during the final episode of Seinfeld? Is that A, Good Riddance, The Time of Your Life, B, American Idiot, C, Basket Case, D, Wake Me Up When It's September Ends? This popular song by Green Day is a melodic and reflective track that has become synonymous with the endings and farewells. Its inclusion in the final episode of Seinfeld adds an emotional touch as the beloved sitcom comes to a close, allowing viewers to reminisce about the journey that they shared with the characters over the years. A, Good Riddance, Time of Your Life has been since become an iconic theme for graduations, farewells, just significant life moments. All right, guys, let's move on to question number two. Who performed at the Super Bowl halftime show in 2021? Not that long ago. A, Beyonce, B, Lady Gaga, C, The Weeknd, or D, Bruno Mars? The performer at the Super Bowl halftime show in 2021 was The Weeknd. The Canadian singer-songwriter took out the stage during the Super Bowl LV, held on to the February 7, 2021 at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. The Weeknd delivered a memorable and visually stunning performance featuring his popular hits such as Blinding Lights, I Can't Feel My Face, Starboy. The halftime show drew a praise for its elaborate production, energetic performances, and C, The Weeknd's unique style, making it a highlight Super Bowl event. All right, let's move on to question number three. And I want to say we have a huge sponsor to our friends over at Jarritos. Yes. Damn.
Tell your mouth to try us, cause we taste super good. Super good, super good, super good. Super good, super good, super good. Cause we just taste super good.
Jarritos!
Thanks, Jarritos. That was super delicious. What talent show? Thanks, Jarritos. That was super delicious. Now let's move on to question number three. What talent show did 12-year-old Beyonce perform on? Is this A, The X Factor, B, Americans Got Talent, C, The Voice, or D, Star Search? It was a popular television competition that aired during the 1980s and 1990s. Beyonce showcased her exceptional vocal abilities and stage presence as a contestant on the show, capturing the attention of audiences, judges with a remarkable talent. Although she did not win the competition, her appearance on the D Star Search served as a stepping stone in her journey towards becoming one of the most successful and influential artists in all of music history. All right, let's move on to question number four. What is Elton John's real name? Is it A, Reginald Dwight, B, John Lennon, C, David Bowie, or D, Michael Jackson? He adopted the stage name Elton John in the early stages of his music career. The name Elton John was inspired by the names of two of his bandmates, Elton Dean and Long John Baldry. A, Reginald Dwight legally changed his name to Elton Hercules John in 1972, making it his official and widely recognized name as a musician and cultural icon. Crazy, right? All right, guys, let's move on to the final question of the day. Last question. Let's get it right. Let's get you guys hooked up. All right, what song is played here?
Grips on your waist, front way, back way. You know that I don't play. Streets not safe, but I never run away. Even when I'm away, O-T, O-T, there's never
more. All right, is this A, Rolling in the Deep, B, Uptown Funk, C, One Dance, or D, Can't Stop the Feeling? It became the first song to reach 1 billion plays on the music streaming platform Apple Music. This was a milestone achieved in 2017, making it a significant achievement for both Drake and the platform itself. The catchy blend of pop, dance hall, Afro beats in C, One Dance resonated with the listeners worldwide, contributing to its immense popularity and record-breaking success on various music platforms. The song's infectious rhythm and memorable lyrics solidified its place in one of Drake's most successful and influential tracks. Anyways, that concludes today's round of music trivia. Thank you guys so much for playing today. Make sure you sign up for the Freckle TV account and set up your user profile after the game and start winning your raffle tickets, man. Telling you, it's awesome stuff in there. I'll be back tomorrow for the worldwide trivia, and see you guys. Have a great rest of your day. How y'all doing? So check it out, it is Wednesday, August 16th, and I'm your trivia host, Giuliano Hodges. I'm super stoked to be here every Wednesday for all around the world trivia. Each Wednesday, we're sitting and jetting around all across the world with five different questions that will test your knowledge to the furthest corners of this planet. So, just a little reminder, Freckle TV is the only platform where you can win amazing prizes using your brain. All you have to do is play every day, answer five questions, earn your raffle tickets, and then head to the prize marketplace. Simple, sweet, and delicious. All right, let's move on to question number one. According to their calendar, which country is 7 years behind the rest of the world? Is this A, China, B, Japan, C, Iran, or D, Ethiopia? So Ethiopia follows the Ethiopian calendar, also known as the GE's calendar. I could be pronouncing that wrong. Sorry, Ethiopian fam. Which is based on the ancient Coptic calendar. D, the Ethiopian calendar has a different calculation for determining the year. It is approximately 7 to 8 years behind the Gregorian calendar used in most parts of the world. For example, while it may be the year 2023 now in the Gregorian calendar, it would be around 2015 or 2016 in the Ethiopian calendar. Take me back. Shit. All right. Let's move on to question number two. What is the most volcanogenic country in the world? Is this A, Indonesia, B, Japan, C, Iceland, or D, Philippines? Located in the Pacific Ring of Fire, a region known for its high volcanic and seismic activity, it is home to the vast number of active volcanoes, which is over 130 active volcanoes, crazy, including famous ones like Mount Krakatoa, I think, Mount Merapi, Mount Tambora. A, Indonesia experiences frequent volcanic eruptions and volcanic-related phenomena. The country's unique geological positioning and rich volcanic soil have also contributed to the fertile landscapes and agricultural productivity. All right, let's move on to question number three. Before we do so, I want to give a quick shout-out to our boys over at Happy Dad. Shout-out to my boys at Nelk. And obviously, if you're drinking this, full send it, but also drink responsibly. Thanks, Happy Dad. Mad delicious as always. All right, let's move on to question number three. What country produces the most coffee in the world today? Is this A, Colombia, B, Brazil, C, Ethiopia, or D, Vietnam? With its vast coffee plantations spread across various regions, it has established itself as the leading global producer and exporter of coffee. The country benefits from the favorable climate conditions, suitable terrain, and advanced agricultural practices, allowing it to cultivate and yield such significant quantities of high-quality coffee beans. B, Brazilian coffee is renowned for its rich flavor profiles and plays a vital role in global coffee industry. All right, let's move on to question number four. Which country has the most Muslims in the world? Is this A, Saudi Arabia, B, Pakistan, C, Indonesia, or D, Turkey? With a predominantly Muslim population, C, Indonesia, is the home to the largest number of Muslims globally. Islam is the predominant religion in this country, and Muslims constitute a significant majority of the population. The diverse Muslim community in Indonesia follows various Islamic traditions, practices, and contributing to the country's rich Islamic heritage and cultural identity. All right, guys, we're now finally moving on to the last question of the day, so pay close attention and don't miss it. What state has the longest coastline? Is this A, Alaska, B, California, C, Florida, or D, Hawaii? So due to the extensive networks of fjords, bays, and islands, it boasts a remarkable coastline that stretches approximately 6,640 miles, which is 10,686 kilometers. This vast coastline is more than double the combined coastlines of all the other U.S. states. A, Alaska's rugged and diverse coastal landscape offers a breathtaking scenery of abundant wildlife and ample opportunities for activities such as fishing, boating, wildlife viewing. It's amazing. All right. That concludes today's episode of All Around the World Trivia. Thank you guys so much for playing today. It's been an amazing first day with all of you. And shoot, make sure you sign up for Freckle TV's account and set up your user profile after the game. Start earning those raffle tickets, guys. I'll be back tomorrow for Freckle University. See you later, and have a wonderful rest of your day. And stay fresh. What is going on, people? How the fudge you doing? We in here getting smart today. It is Thursday, August 17th, and I'm your trivia host, Giuliano Hodges. Thursdays, we're taking you back to school with Freckle University. Freckle U is our big brain player's time to shine. This is for the real geniuses out there. You know who you are, so let's get this in the bag. Every Thursday will be a different academic topic, but don't worry, as always, correctness of answer doesn't really have anything to do with your daily earnings. It's just a little bruise on your ego, so. But all you have to do is play every day, answer all five questions, get them all right or get them all wrong, you're still getting to get your raffle tickets. Now, before we start, I just want to give a quick shout out to our sponsors at Diamond Select, Olipop, Journey Club, Doge Pound NFT, Razer Gaming, and Kaiju Kings. Thank you guys for being with us, and let's get this party started. Everyone be seated. School is officially in session, and today is science trivia. Woo-hoo-hoo! Yeah! Let's get started with question number one. What general name is also given to the natural satellites? Is it A, asteroids, B, comets, C, moons, or D, planets? These are celestial bodies that orbit around the planet or other larger objects in space, and the term C, moon, is not specific to Earth's natural satellite. It is a general term used to describe the natural satellites of other planets as well. For example, Jupiter has over 80 known moons. Saturn has over 80 known, even dwarf planets like Pluto have moons. So moon serves as a common term for natural satellites in our solar system and beyond. Cool stuff. All right, let's move on to question number two. What is known as the master gland of the human body? Is that A, the thyroid gland, B, adrenal gland, B, pituitary gland, or D, the pineal gland? It is a small pea-sized gland located at the base of the brain. It is a bony cavity called the stella terschitia. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, all right. All right, despite its small size, C, the pituitary gland plays a crucial role in regulating and controlling various bodily functions. It produces and releases hormones that regulate growth, metabolism, reproduction, stress response, and other endocrine functions. The pituitary gland, God, that word is just not good with my tongue and lips and beautiful, juicy face. Pituitary gland is often referred to as the master gland because it influences and controls the activities of other endocrine glands throughout the body. I love that how pineal gland is one of those. That's the third eye, just in case you're woke. All right, let's move on to question number three. But before we do so, check out this video from one of our sponsors. We'll be right back. All right, shout out to our amazing season one sponsors. Now let's head on to question number three. So, how much taller is the Eiffel Tower during the summer? What? Is it A, 6 inches, B, 1 foot, C, 5 feet, or D, 20 feet? So it is made of wrought iron and has a height of 300 meters, not including the antennas that were added later. However, the height of the tower can be changed depending on the temperature. This is because the metal expands when heated and contracts and is cooled, and it's a phenomenon known as thermal expansion. In summer, when the temperature is higher and the metal of the tower expands, it makes it taller, and in the winter, when temperature is lower, the metal of the tower contracts and makes it shorter. According to some sources, the Eiffel Tower can grow up to 6 inches taller in the summer. I wish. Okay, let's move on to question number four. The Horsehead Nebula can be found in what constellation? Is it A, Ursa Major, B, Orion, C, Cassiopeia, or D, Andromeda? It is located just below the three prominent stars of B, Orion's Belt. The Horsehead Nebula is a dark nebula which appears as a distinctive silhouette resembling the shape as a horse head against the bright background of an emission nebula. It is the popular target for astrophotography and observation due to its unique and captivating appearance in the sky. All right, we're now officially moving on to the final of the question, so pay close attention and let's knock this one out. The world's fastest growing plant is a species of what? Is it A, bamboo, B, fern, C, cactus, or D, sunflower? Certain species of bamboo have exceptionally fast growth rates, which some capable of growing up to 36 inches per day. Mind-boggling. This rapid growth primarily attributed to unique structure and the characteristics of bamboo, such as its hollow stems, rapid cell division, and efficient photosynthesis. The fast growth of a bamboo makes it highly renewable and sustainable resource with wide range of application. If you throw some bamboo and start growing it, you can't stop it. So, you know, be wary. All right, so that concludes today's round of Freckle University. Thank you guys so much for playing today. Make sure you sign up for Freckle TV account and set your user profile after this game so you can start earning those raffle tickets. Those are important, guys. The legend himself, LT, Lord Trivia himself, will be back tomorrow for a round of Freckle fun, and we'll see you guys next week. Freckle fam, hang out, be cool, be vibey, be swag, and be nice to your peers. Peace.
What's up, Freckle family? You know what day it is, TGIFF. Thank God it's Freckle Fridays, August 18th, and I'm your daily trivia host, Ian Finer, AKA Lord Trivia himself. Most of you know how this works already, but I have to give a reminder for our new players that Freckle TV is the daily trivia game where you can tune in every Monday through Friday, answer 5 questions, and earn raffle tickets to spend in our prize marketplace. Yo, go check out that prize marketplace. Make sure you create your Freckle TV account and start earning today. Now, before we get started, let's shout out some sponsors at Happy Dad, Jarito Soda, Diamond Select, CyberCon's Cryptoon Goons, and Avagachi. So, let's get started with question number one. What is the symbol for copper? Is it A, AG, B, CU, CC, or D, CO? The symbol is derived from the Latin word cuprum, which translates to from Cyprus. This is because copper was historically mined and traded extensively on the Mediterranean island of Cyprus. Over time, the symbol BCU became widely accepted and used to represent copper in scientific contexts. Copper is a versatile metal known for its excellent conductivity, malleability, and resistance to corrosion, making it valuable in various industries, including electrical wiring, plumbing, and electronics. Now let's head to question number two. Which country is famous for the fast food chain Jollibee? Is it A, China, B, South Korea, C, Japan, or D, the Philippines? Jollibee is a popular fast food restaurant known for its unique menu, which includes items like Chicken Joy, fried chicken, Jolly Spaghetti, and peach mango pie. Founded in 1978 by Tony Tan Kakchiang, Jollibee has become a beloved icon in Filipino cuisine and has expanded internationally with branches in several countries around the world. The brand's mascot, a smiling red and yellow bee named Jollibee, has become synonymous with Filipino fast food culture. Now let's head to question number three. Question number three, sponsored, is one of our sponsor questions. Check out this video from one of our sponsors. Shout out to our amazing season one sponsors. Now let's head to question number three. Monza and Silverstone are venues for which sport? Is it A, Formula One racing, B, tennis, C, golf, or D, cycling? Monza Circuit, officially known as Autodromo Nazionale Monza, is located near Monza, Italy. It has been hosting Formula One races since the championship's inception in 1950. Monza is renowned for its high-speed straights and historic significance, as it is one of the oldest and most iconic circuits in our answer, A, Formula One. The Silverstone Circuit, located in North Hampshire, England, is another historic circuit in Formula One. Now let's head to question number four. Which programming language shares its name with an island in Indonesia? Is it A, Java, B, Python, C, Ruby, or D, C++? It is a widely used programming language that was created by James Gosling and his team at Sun Microsystems, now owned by Oracle, in the mid-1990s. The name A, Java, was chosen as a reference to the Indonesian island of Java, known for its rich culture and coffee production. The language gained popularity for its write once, run anywhere approach, allowing code to be executed on any platform that supports Java, making it a versatile and widely adopted programming language. Hey, here's a fun fact. The Freckle TV platform is built using a form of JavaScript. Anyway, let's head to the final question of the day. What is James Bond's preferred drink of choice? Is it A, a martini, B, a mojito, C, a margarita, or D, mimosa? Well, James Bond's preferred drink of choice is ordered as shaken and not stirred. This iconic phrase became synonymous with the character and has been referenced in numerous James Bond films and novels. While Bond has been known to enjoy other drinks as well as our answer, A, the vodka martini has become his signature cocktail. It represents his sophisticated and suave personality as well as his appreciation for the finer things in life. The line, shaken, not stirred, has become a pop culture reference often associated with the character of James Bond. In fact, I literally can't go to a bar and order a martini without saying shaken, not stirred. And that's just because I'm a jerk. Anyway, that concludes this week of Daily Trivia. Thank you so much for playing, and make sure you sign up for a Freckle TV account, make that profile, and start earning tickets. I don't know what you're waiting for. If you want to keep up with all the Freckle community and the amazing stuff we've got going on outside of Daily Trivia, follow us on socials. Hop in our Discord server, discord.gg/freckle. Follow us on Twitter at Freckle Trivia, and on TikTok to see all of our TikTok shenanigans at Freckle TV. We should probably just consolidate all those socials. Anywho, John Bailey will be back after the weekend for more Movie Mondays. LT signing off for the week. Have a great weekend.